Hello guys and welcome back. Our today's topic is the assembly language program for addition of a series of 8-bit numbers. That means till now we have done the computation of 1-bit number or 2 8-bit numbers, right? But now we need to find the addition of a series of 8-bit numbers. That means we have to take input many numbers through a data array. And we need to find the summation of all those numbers. So in this program, we will use the concept of an array. So what we will do? We will first input the total number of elements in an array. That means how many numbers are present in the series. So let's take an example. And the total number of elements in that array or a series is 5. Okay. So there are 5 elements. 0, 3, A, 1, 3 and 7. Okay. And these numbers are inputted through some continuous memory location. So let's say I am inputting this data from C051. Okay, then this will be in C052, then C053, C054 and C055. Okay, these are the addresses of these datas. Now we need to add them. So how we will do it? As we know, all the operations are being performed in the accumulator. So in the beginning, we will initialize the accumulator with 00, okay? Then we will take the first input and add it with the accumulator. So it will be added, right? And we will get 03 hex. Now, side by side, we will decrement the value of C. This was 5, now it will be 4. So this was the first step. Then what? Then again, the content of accumulator will be added with the second data. So 03 plus 0A is equals to 0D, right? And C will be decremented. So it will be 03 hex. Now in the third step, again, the third data will be added with the content of accumulator. That means 0D plus 01 is equals to 0E hex. And C will be 02, right? As we have decremented it. Then in the next step, A will be 0E plus 03. So it will give us 11 hex in hexadecimal, and side by side decrement C, so it will be 01 hex. Now in the last step, 11 will be added with 7. Okay, so we will get 18, right? And now C will be 00. Then see here, the content of C becomes 00. Okay, this was the number of elements in the array. So when it becomes 00, that means we have added up all the elements in that array. This will be the answer and we will store it in some location. Now one thing you can notice here is all the time we are adding a new element with the accumulator and decrementing the content of C. Okay, as there are 5 elements, so we have performed this operation 5 times here. So here for these operations, we will use loop so that the code does not become too long. Now let's write the assembly language program. So in the beginning, we will input the total number of elements. Okay, so let's input it LXI H, C050 hex. Okay, and this is the total number of elements. So I am moving it in the register C. Now one thing, we need to initialize the accumulator with 00, right? So that it does not contain any garbage value and we don't get any wrong answer. So MVI E, 00 hex. And one thing here I forgot, that we also need to keep track of carry. That is, if a carry is generated or not, then we need to add it too. So for carry part, we are initializing a register B with 00. Okay. Now we will start inputting all the elements one by one, right? So INX H, this will input the first data. Now just after inputting the first data, we need to add it with the content of accumulator. So we will perform add, this is M. Okay, so A will be A plus M. That means A is 00 and M is the first data, that is 03. So it will be containing 03 hex. Now after addition, we need to check whether the carry is generated or not. So we will use a JNC instruction. Okay. So if a carry is not generated, we will jump to some location. Let's say here. But if a carry is generated, then we need to store that carry part. So we will increment the value of B, which is used here for storing the carry. So INR B. Okay. Now if a carry is generated or not generated, next step is to decrement the content of C. That means this step. Now after decrementing, we need to check whether this number, that is the total number of elements now, is zero or not, right? See here, we kept on checking, and when it becomes zero, then the process is stopped. So we will use JNZ instruction. Okay, this is also a loop. So jump if no zero, that means if the content C is not equals to zero, then we will jump to some location. So when it is not equals to zero, it means that we again need to perform the same operations. So it will go somehow here. Okay, so this keep loop will go to this location. Why? Because see, if C is not equals to zero, then we will again increment the second data. We will again add, checking for carry, and again decrementing the content of C. Then again the same loop will be repeated until the content of C becomes 00. Okay, so I hope this loop part is clear. Now when C becomes 00, then what? We need to store the result and the carry part. So as we know that all the data are being added up in the accumulator, right? You can see here. So we will store the result in some location. Okay, I'm storing it in D000 hex address. Now we need to store the carry part, and it is present in the register B. So first we will move it into the accumulator, and then we will store it in some location, let's say D001 hex, and then halt. So this is the process by which we can add a series of numbers. Okay, so if we talk about output here, then in case of our example, D000 hex will be containing 18 hex, and D001 hex will be containing 00, as there is no carry. So I hope this program is clear to you now. If you like this video, please support the channel by subscribing to it. See you in the next video. Thank you.